Comets are the ghosts of the solar system. They are dirty snowballs moving around in the solar system in elliptical orbits around the sun, and only when they get close to the sun, they develop a tail that we can see from the Earth. So the comets basically are the building blocks of the solar system. So if we can understand comets, we can actually understand the formation of our solar system. And then we can understand how water came to Earth, and we can understand how life started. That's why scientists today always want to touch a comet. And this year, this will actually happen. The Rosetta spacecraft was launched 10 years ago, traveling for 6 billion kilometers, chasing a comet deep out in space. It even brings with it Norwegian technology to find its way. It's been moving around in the solar system as a ping pong ball between the planets and reaches a speed now of 58,000 kilometers per hour, chasing a comet moving with only 55,000 kilometers per hour. Think about this. It's like trying to hit an object moving 55 times faster than a bullet after 10 years' journey. And last week, some tense moments when the spacecraft slowed down to match the speed of the comet, going into an orbit, and for the first time in history, we actually got a really close-up picture of a comet and how it looks like before it gets a tail, before we can see it. And those pictures you probably saw online have stunned people. Very structured, very strange shape, and we've never seen pictures like this before, ever, in history. The spacecraft is going to continue orbiting the comet to search for a landing spot, because in November this year, a small landing module, Philia, will actually descend down to the surface and land on a comet. And for the first time in mankind history, we will actually land on a comet and try to investigate and understand what it's made of. So right now, space history has been written deep, deep out in space. So I'm Pål Brekke. I'm chasing comets for a living. Thank you.